Today we're gonna make mashed potatoes, and they're really good. Wash your hands beforehand, which I already did, and now we're going to wash the potatoes under a little brimming water to get the dirt off. And once you've done that, you want to cut them all into quarters, or if you have really big potatoes, you can do halves. Just be sure to cut them all the same size so they cook the same. So the next thing you want to do after you finish cutting up all the potatoes is put some water on the stove. We'll fill a pot about 3/4 or 2/3 full and start boiling it. If you're in a hurry, you can put it on before. And then just put a little salt in there so that it doesn't boil over too bad. And then potatoes in. So it's going to take a while for the water to boil and the potatoes to cook. So in the meantime, wash the chives or green onions. I have green onions, but chives are fine. Wash them and cut them up. And you can add them in at the end. Alright. So next, what you want to do with the green onions is kind of line up the ends and chop them into really fine pieces. And be sure you curl your fingers under so that you don't get cut with the knife. So cut all the way down to the ends and then take the ends and save them for other stuff. And then set those aside and wait for the potatoes to cook. When the potatoes have been boiling for 45 minutes or so, check them with a fork. If they split apart really easily, that means they're done, and you can take them off and drain them in the sink. Now, careful, because this part gives. Put the potatoes back in the warm pot just after about a minute, and add in a little bit of buttermilk and a little bit of salt and start mixing. After you mash them up a little bit, add the butter. About one of the cubes would be good for one batch, and use a pot holder. Stop and add more buttermilk as needed. You can do regular milk, but it won't taste the same. And it doesn't, just add it how much you need to keep it fluid, well not fluid, but moist enough. Don't go over half of the part. After they're all mashed up, add some of the black pepper. So, after you're done and they're to the desired taste, add in about 3/4 of the chives, or green onions you cut up, and I'm using the rest in another dish. And then you can mix them in, and then sprinkle a few on top for presentation.